Welcome back to the What an Idiom podcast. About a week ago, Finland celebrated Vappu, or May Day. Vappu is a Finnish, originally working class festivity that in modern times is basically like St. Patrick's Day without all the leprechauns, shamrock themed drinks, or an emphasis on the color green. Staples of the Finnish May Day include confetti, serpentine, mead, and some stronger beverages. So in the spirit of Vappu, we're gonna look at some phrases that insinuate someone's had a drink or two, maybe. There's really no shortage of euphemisms for being drunk, whether you're speaking English or Finnish, so let's just get to the bottom of this. Tipsy, as in, I'm not really drunk, I'm just a little tipsy. Tipsy is by far the most commonly used adjective for someone who's had a few drinks and is getting a bit silly, but it's also people's go-to expression when they're trying to downplay how drunk they really are. It's a nice little word. Three sheets to the wind. Someone who's three sheets to the wind is visibly quite drunk. This phrase comes from seafaring slang. The word sheets refers to ropes that hold the sails at place, so if three of those ropes are loose and tossed around by the wind, you can imagine how out of control the sail is. Does this sound like your Vappu last week? Oh well, moving on. Away with the fairies. This one's more of a general description of someone who's in a world of their own, and the person being described doesn't have to be drunk. Having said that, we've all seen people who are away with the fairies after having a few too many drinks, and this is a fitting use of the expression. Not to mention that away with the fairies does paint a rather hilarious picture. Trolleyed. This one's interesting because, literally speaking, it doesn't talk about how someone looks or acts, but how they got that way. Trolleyed actually refers to drinks trolleys that are pushed through a train or a plane to sell refreshments. You know, like in the Hogwarts Express, but instead of chocolate frogs, a person who's trolleyed decided to get some beverages. Pie-eyed. Oh, he was totally pie-eyed by the time we got there. Pies are round and glazed, so pie-eyed definitely refers to the empty, glazed stare that a drunk person has. Simple, yet elegant. Under the influence. You could clearly tell that he was under the influence. You might know this one from DUI, driving under the influence. Despite its obvious legal origin, you can say that someone's under the influence in everyday conversations as well. And because the US hates keeping things coherent, some states talk about DWIs, driving while intoxicated. So there's another one for you. Intoxicated. Cooter Brown. Cooter Brown is a maybe real, maybe fictional character, best known in the southern United States. The story goes that Cooter Brown resided on the line between the North and the South during the American Civil War, and because he didn't want to fight in the war, he decided to stay drunk enough that neither army would want him in their ranks. Good old Cootie Brown. Now, brace yourselves, because I'm going to tackle a good bunch of these next without any further explanations. The next time your friends are drunk, just say that they're wasted, hammered, plastered, thrashed, sloshed, shit-faced, drunk as a skunk, legless, buzzed, well-oiled, mortaled, inebriated, intoxicated, destroyed, off their tits, boiled in the bag, pickled, decimated, under full sail, goggled, ratted, or blackout drunk. Is that enough? Maybe not. I'll put a link in the description where you can see Jamie Dornan from 50 Shades mention 41 different phrases for drunk. That should pretty much cover the English phrases, so we shall move on to the Finnish vernacular next. Hiprakassa. It's hard to provide a literal translation for this one, but in some Finnish dialects, hiprakka means a little bit. So when you're hiprakassa, you're a little bit drunk. So this is basically the Finnish equivalent of tipsy. Pienessä sievässä. In a little cute one. Pienessä sievässä is another way to say someone is slightly drunk or tipsy. However, Finns are rarely cute when they're drunk, so let's look at a few heavy hitters. Perseet olalla. This is a phrase that you hear Finns purposely use a lot when joking in English. Persetolalla literally means asses on shoulders, so it's a good thing to say when you want to humor foreigners. Despite the funny imagery, this expression simply means very drunk. Every now and then people also leave out olalla, so they just say someone was perseet. Kännissä kuin käki. Drunk as a cuckoo. The first word, kännissä, simply means drunk, and that word alone is the most common way to say someone's drunk in Finnish. The cuckoo bird part sounds odd, although some boozies might make similar sounds to cuckoo birds, but the most likely explanation is in alliteration. Kännissä and käki share the first two letters, which makes them a good pair for a humorous expression. Säiden ohuet päiväkännit. Literally, thin as a web, daytime intoxication. Säiden ohut päiväkänni is a funny expression that young women, more than anyone else, use to disguise their day drinking. Sometimes the word ranskalaistyylinen, French style, gets thrown in there to produce säiden ohut ranskalaistyylinen päiväkänni, which supposedly makes your daytime buzz sound more sophisticated. It's worth noting that for the most part, this phrase is used humorously among friends, and quite often the drinking won't stop once you reach your thin-as-a-web buzz. For the most part, people want to be quick and concise with their words, so Finnish has a number of one-word expressions for being inebriated. Here are some of them. Kännissä. Lärvit. Kaasussa. Naamat. Tuiterissa, seilissä, tunnelissa, jurrissa, maistissa, juovuksissa, seipäät, tuubassa, päissään, laitamyötäisessä, nakit silmillä, tumut, and kekkulissa. Phew. I think that's plenty for now. I'm sure I missed some hilarious Finnish expressions, because these tend to come and go. But if you can't find a suitable word or phrase from among these ones, I really can't help you. If you know of any funny idioms that weren't included here, leave a comment. That's it for this week's What an Idiom. So, until the next time, toodles, see ya, and hey pa hey.